Now let us look at this question. This question is a very simple question which is asked in GATE 2015, and it was in set 1 and it was a 2-mark question. Okay. Now this is a very, very simple question. Now there are a few terminologies that you need to take care for this particular question. In the previous videos, we discussed about the simple flow control protocol. And when I'm saying simple flow control protocol, it means that it is also called as a stop and wait protocol. There are two types of protocol. Number one is stop and wait protocol, and second one is a stop and wait ARQ protocol. Stop and wait protocol is just a simple flow control protocol, but if you add stop and wait repeat request, automatic repeat request, then it becomes stop and wait ARQ. Don't worry, later on in the later videos, we are also going to discuss about the stop and wait ARQ. Right now, we are just discussing about the stop and wait protocol. So they are saying, suppose that the stop and wait protocol is used on a link with a bit rate of 64 kbps and 20 milliseconds as a propagation delay. Assume that the transmission time for the acknowledgement and the processing time at the nodes are negligible. Then the minimum frame size in bytes to achieve a link utilization of at least 50% is, you need the link utilization, or you can say efficiency, as at least 50%. Now there are a few terminologies which are important here. Number one is the bit rate. Bit rate means they are discussing about the bandwidth of the network. Bandwidth is actually given in bit rates. Second is frame size. So frame size and the packet size here, it is the same. So generally, when we have a packet, packet is a very generic term. So when we have a packet which is in data link layer, then that is called as a frame. Okay. So here, because we are discussing about the data link layer, that is why the packet is called as a frame. Packet is generic. Even if the packet is in network layer, even if it is transport layer, or even if it is data link layer, in all these three cases, we will call it as packet because it is a generic term. But we have terms which are related to the layers also. Like here we have the data link layer, and the data link layer, the packet is also called as a frame, right? In transport layer and in network layer, we have different names that we'll be discussing about in the later videos. Now, the frame size is, they're asking in byte. If you have the efficiency or link utilization as greater than 50%, see, at least they're saying at least 50%. That means you need the efficiency which should be greater than 50%. 50% is a minimum efficiency. Okay. Now, we know what is a stop and wait protocol. In the last video, we already discussed it. And what is the efficiency of stop and wait protocol? Efficiency of stop and wait protocol can be given by transmission time plus 2 into propagation time, that we already discussed. Efficiency is transmission time upon transmission time plus 2 into propagation time. Now, here they are giving us what is the propagation time. They are already giving us what is the propagation time, and the propagation time is 20 milliseconds. Therefore, propagation time TP is equal to 20 milliseconds. Secondly, what is the transmission time? So transmission time, we already know it is given by length upon of the data packet upon bandwidth of the network. They're not giving us what is the transmission time. They are just saying the transmission time of the acknowledgement is negligible. What does it mean that the transmission time of the acknowledgement is negligible? Assuming that this is the sender and this is the receiver. So sender is going to transmit some data packet here. The data packet will come to the transmission media. Then it will travel through the transmission media. And then we are going to take the data packet on the receiver's end. And at the receiver's end, initially the data packet is going to be stay in the queue, and then it is going to be processed. And later on, the receiver is going to create the acknowledgement, and then receiver is going to transmit this acknowledgement onto this link. Now, when they are saying the transmission time of acknowledgement is zero, that means this transmission time, this exact transmission time of acknowledgement is zero. You can ignore this transmission time because it is so small, because acknowledgements are so small, that the transmission time of acknowledgement is zero, but the propagation time will not be zero. And secondly, they are saying the processing time at the nodes are negligible. Processing time, this processing time, this queuing delay, it is negligible. They are currently saying it is negligible. And for queuing delay, they are not saying anything. That means we can just ignore the queuing delay. It is not given in any case. In some cases, it may be given, but just saying that here, because they are not mentioning the queuing delay, that is why the queuing delay will be zero. I hope this is fine. Now let us look at it. We know that we need efficiency which should be at least 50%, at least 50%. So when I'm saying at least 50%, that means your efficiency should be greater than or equal to 50%. Efficiency should be greater than or equal to 50%. And this 50% mean, what does this 50% mean? 50% means it is 50 divided by 100, or you can say it is 1 upon by 2. Therefore, this formula can also be written as 1 upon 2 less than equal to TT upon TT plus 2 into TP. Now, further you can manipulate these formulas. How you can manipulate? You can cross multiply it here, and you can cross multiply this thing here. So this entire formula can also be written in this manner. It can be written as TT plus 2 into TP should be less than equal to 2 into TT. We have just done a cross multiplication in this formula. And when you take this TT on this side, so this will be 2TP should be less than or equal to TT, because this TT will be subtracted from 2 into TT. Okay, now this is an important result. This is an important result. Why I'm saying this is an important result? Because you can further break these formulas. How will you break it? It can be written as 2 into TP should be less than or equal to length upon bandwidth. It should be less than or equal to length upon bandwidth. Why? Because we just inserted this value of TT at this place. Hence, this formula can also be written like this. 2 into TP multiplied by bandwidth should be less than or equal to length. Should be less than or equal to length. And this length means length of the data packet. They are clearly asking what should be the minimum frame size in bytes, or the packet size in case of bytes. That means they are just asking the value of this length in terms of bytes. Hence, we already know what is the value of TP. TP is given as 20 milliseconds. So this is 20 milliseconds. And we already know what is the bandwidth. Bandwidth is given as 64 kilobits per second. So this is 64 kbps. Now, when I'm saying it is 20 milliseconds and this is given in terms of second, therefore you have to convert this 20 milliseconds in terms of seconds. Hence, this will be 2 into 20 divided by 1000. Why I'm saying 2 into 20 divided by 1000? Because in 1 second, there are 1000 milliseconds. Therefore, in 1 millisecond, there are 1 upon 1000 seconds. So if I have to convert this 20 milliseconds, then I'm just going to multiply this value by 20. So it will be 20 divided by 1000 multiplied by the bandwidth. Bandwidth is given as 64 kbps. KB as I told you, KB is kilobits per second, and kilo here in case of bandwidth is represented in the powers of 10. So it will be multiplied by 1000 bits per second, or bits upon second. Here it is 20 milliseconds. So this is second, and that is bits upon second, should be less than or equal to length. Hence, you can cancel out these seconds. You can cancel out this 1000. So the length of the data packet should be greater than, this is 64 into 20 is going to be, 64 into 20 is going to be 1280, and multiplied by 2 is going to be 061, and this will be 245, and this is 2. That means it should be 2560 bits. Length should be greater than 2560 bits. Now here clearly they are asking it should be given in terms of byte. Byte means, if this is a bit, if you want to convert these bits into bytes, then you have to divide this by 8. So you have to divide 2560 divide by 8 as the byte. So length of the data packet should be greater than this. So what is 2560 divided by 8? So that can be written as 320. So the length of the data packet should be greater than 320 bytes. Length of the data packet should be greater than 320 bytes. So answer to this question is 320. See, I've taken time to solve this question because I was explaining you the entire procedure. But you can also understand it easily because when you solve this question in the examination hall, it will hardly take 30 seconds for you to solve if you know the entire procedure. The best way to solve the questions is to practice as much as possible. And obviously, we are going to give you a lot of practice problems, and obviously, we are going to cover all the previous year gate problems and UGC NET problems. Okay? I hope you enjoyed this question. Now, let us go to the next question.